From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Tisha Bader.
I'm Tisha Bader with the JBS News Features Edition for Friday, May the 28th, 2021. Over 300 rabbis from various streams of Judaism have signed onto a letter publicly reaffirming their support for Israel and standing against those attacking Israel and attacking Jews around the world. The letter is spearheaded by a new organization called the Zionist Rabbinic Coalition, made up of Reform, Conservative, and Orthodox rabbis. Founder and Chairman Rabbi Stuart Weinblatt, who also leads Congregation B'nai Tzedek in Potomac, Maryland, said that now more than ever, the Jewish community and the rabbinic community in particular must counter the voices of those who disparage Israel. He also said the environment was leading some elected officials to feel it is safe to question longstanding U.S. support for Israel and is contributing to an environment conducive to anti-Semitism and attacks on Jews, stressing that it's important for rabbis to lead and show that we will not stand by and tolerate such outbursts, nor shall we be silent and allow support for our only democratic ally in the Middle East to be diminished. Holocaust survivor and advocate Roman Kent has died. Kent, who survived the Lodz ghetto, served as chairman of the American Gathering of Jewish Holocaust Survivors and Their Descendants, as well as president of the International Auschwitz Committee and president of the Jewish Foundation for the Righteous. He was also a veteran board member of the Conference on Jewish Material Claims Against Germany, known as the Claims Conference, where he negotiated billions of dollars in pensions and compensation for Jewish survivors. Claims Conference President Gideon Taylor called Kent an undeniable advocate for the global Jewish community. Roman Kent died last Friday. He was 92. Well, we end with a sign of hope for Jewish-Arab relations in Israel. As we reported to you during the conflict between Israel and terror group Hamas, tensions in Jewish-Arab communities in Israel rose significantly, much of which was incited by Hamas. And there were several assaults committed by extremist Arabs on Jews and by extremist Jews on Arabs in towns and cities in Israel that normally are symbols of peaceful coexistence. 56-year-old Yigal Yehoshua was killed by Arab rioters in the city of Lod, and 17-year-old Muhammad Mahmoud Kiwan died during riots and clashes with Israel police in Umm al-Fahim. The cause of his death is still being investigated. Both families made the decision to donate the organs of their loved ones. And Yehoshua's kidney went to a 59-year-old Palestinian woman from Jerusalem who expressed her deep gratitude and also called for peace between Jews and Arabs. Yehoshua's brother Ephraim said, "I think that we may be a symbol of coexistence," stressing that saving lives, no matter whose, was what was crucial here. Kiwan's organs went to 5 Jewish patients, including a teenage girl who received his kidney and a 37-year-old man who received his heart. A 1-year-old Arab baby received a part of his liver. Kiwan's father, Mahmoud, said he was proud that his son's organ saved the lives of so many. He said, "We wish them full recovery, whatever and whoever they are." Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Friday, May the 28th. Live Shabbat services are coming up at 6 o'clock from New York City's Central Synagogue, followed by Shabbat services from the Hampton Synagogue at 8:30, IDF musicians in concert. At 9, it's the film The Saga of a Photo, a love story that crosses borders. At 10:30, a replay of the Hampton Synagogue services, followed by an encore presentation from Central Synagogue. And coming up next, a look at this week's Torah portion. And that's the JBS News Features Edition for Friday, May the 28th, 2021. I'm Tisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well, and Shabbat Shalom.